Filipino weightlifting champion Heidilyn Diaz looking forward to winning more medals for the Philippines following her historic victory in the Tokyo Games. On Monday, Diaz became the first Filipino to win an Olympic gold after she topped the 55 kilogram category. She posted a new world record, lifting a combined weight of 224 kilograms, cementing her place in Philippine and Olympic history. Prior to the Games, a 30-year-old Diaz had been contemplating retirement, but she's now setting that aside.
Hindi ako magsa-stop kasi kaya ko pa. Nakita ko yung galing ko and alam ko may ibibigay pa ako para sa Pilipinas.
Diaz now has a collection of one Olympic gold and a silver, which she won in the 2016 Rio Games. The Zamboanga native hopes her victory will inspire all Filipinos amid these trying times.
Kahit na sa pandemic na kaya natin, na-survive ko, na-survive ng team EFC, na-survive ng Pilipinas, Philippine team. Nagawa natin kahit sabihin na nasa pandemic nandito tayo and risky, pero naiuwi natin ang medalya. Walang imposible. Hindi pa rin ako makapaniwala na nanalo ako ng gold. Hanggang ngayon, pero ugaw ko na, it's, yun, hindi ako makapaniwala nandito. Pero sobrang thankful ako.
Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo congratulating Heidilyn Diaz on social media. She thanked the weightlifter for making Filipinos proud. She also praised Diaz for her dedication and hard work in spite of the obstacles in her way. The palace also congratulating Diaz for bringing pride and glory to the Philippines. Praises continue to pour in for the country's first Olympic gold medalist, Heidilyn Diaz. The Philippine Air Force, where the Filipino athlete serves as a sergeant, joins the country in celebrating the historic win. The Olympic gold medalist also getting some love from her hometown, Zamboanga. The Philippine Sports Commission is also congratulating the Filipino sports icon.
Ito po yung pinakaantay natin na after almost 100 years, ito na po yung gold. Kinausap na po tayo ng International Federation na maraming tutulong sa akin, marami tayong ma-attract, everything. Maraming gagawing tournament dyan dahil maraming may inspire. At pag-uusapan po namin kung pwede siyang mag-stay para naman makapagbigay pa ng inspirasyon sa mga iba pang magpa-final. So nagpo-qualify.
Here are the prizes that await Heidilyn Diaz when she comes home. She will receive a total of 35.5 million pesos in cash rewards. 10 million pesos will be coming from the government and 10 million each from businessmen Manny Pangilinan and Ramon Ang. One Pacman Party List representative, Mikey Romero, will be giving 3 million and 2.5 million pesos will come from her hometown, Zamboanga City. These are on top of a house and lot in Tagaytay City, plus a 14 million peso condominium unit in Eastwood City from Mega World tycoon Andrew Tan. A former coach and relative of Heidilyn Diaz reveals she almost quit the sport on account of depression. Catalino Diaz says prior to the 2016 Rio Games, Diaz struggled with not being able to win a medal at the Olympics, but she eventually overcame her insecurity to break the Philippines' medal drought.
Before pa nga ng, ano, yung Rio Olympics, yung time na yun, siguro ikwento ko na lang din konti, no? Gusto na niya rin mag-quit kasi sa tagal-tagal na nag-join siya ng weightlifting and sa Olympics, wala siyang nakukuha. Or yung last na Olympics niya is napaka-bad ng, ano, ng performance niya noon. So sabi niya, kung etong Olympics, hindi pa ako magkakamedal, I will quit na. And nung time na yun, sobrang depressed niya.
Oo. Eh mahirap na ba talaga 'yun?
Opo, yung depression niya is ano eh kasi nagkaroon siya ng injury tapos nawalan siya ng coach noon, tapos less yung support kasi alam naman natin sa sports na ano, hindi talaga ganun yung support.
Meanwhile, another Filipino weightlifter will be competing in Tuesday's Olympic schedule. 22-year-old Elrin Ando is seen as an heir apparent of Heidelin Diaz. She will compete in the 64-kilogram division. Ando won a silver medal in the 2019 Southeast Asian Games. She also won a bronze and two silver medals in the Asian Championships last April.